gone through the back end, we can move to going through the front end page by page. So just to review, it's a very simple app. Its homepage has this featured movie section, and then here a section with two genres and the movies that belong to each genre. If you click on a movie, you'll see the movie detail page, which is extremely similar to the person detail page. We also have the user's profile with the gravatar, username, list of movies, other list of movies. So let's start with the movies. Right away, we know that we have to get an endpoint that tells us the specific information about this movie generically. It doesn't matter if I'm logged in or not, if I can still see the storyline. And also, I have to be able to see stuff while I'm authenticated that I wouldn't see when I'm not authenticated, like my rating. So if you navigate to the web directory and go to source API, moviesapi.js in the React repo, one of the first functions is a getMoviesByGenre function. It gets movies by genre. It spits out a bunch of movies that are in the particular genre. So if we go back to the documentation, it takes in as input action and drama. Here's my action movie. My drama movies. These are hard-coded. I could have put in a different one. Let me go do that real quick. I'll do adventure. To put it here as well. All right, adventure and drama. All right, so to do one of these templates, the movie detail, here you can see the code that makes the page look nice. You grab a movie ID, and then movie API gets the movie on just like we saw before. So this gives you pretty much everything you need to build the page. Related movies, the actors, the directors. To do ratings of movies. I know the ID of the movie up here. I know what user I am because I'm logged in. And I know what I'm going to rate it. So using the Movies API, I can post a rating or delete a rating by posting to this rate endpoint and sending over my rating. Going over to the profile page, let's talk it on create user. So naturally you create a user on the sign up page. There's no delete user here because it's a very simple app. Essentially the user shows up on create account. They put in their username, I'll put Betty3, and their password into the UI, and it sends over the information about the username and the password over to the register endpoint, which works like this. And importantly, it also immediately authenticates you. See, I'm logged in right now. And I can go home to the homepage.